Hi folks! In this video, you will learn the three most important aspects you need to know when documenting the detailed design according to Automotive SPICE. If you're wondering if your software detailed design is sufficiently documented, then you have come to the right place. Just keep on watching. My name is Bhaskar Amali, and I'm a principal assessor and trainer for Automotive SPICE. In my past 13 years at Kugler Mark, I have worked with people all around the globe and trained more than 250 assessors. Since I cover a lot of our international projects, I have a very good insight in the different approaches worldwide. So let's jump right into the video. What is the goal of software detailed design? A lot of organizations and projects have problems understanding how to document the detailed design. So, what are the three aspects you should manage in this process? Aspect 1, level of detail. Often organizations struggle how specific the detailed design should be. A good way to approach this is to remember what the purpose of the detailed design is. It is the basis for the implementation of the code and the unit test. Especially the unit verification requires a detailed description. Here, the level of coverage must be considered. In safety critical software, ISO 26262 provides guidance. In non-safety software, typically at least C0 or statement coverage, by some customers, C1 or branch coverage is required. The higher the coverage goal, the more detail is required by the detailed design. If you have an ASIL-B classified module, a C1 coverage is expected by ISO 26262. That means that your detailed design should identify the different branches of your software. Aspect 2, interfaces. A pitfall I often encounter in assessments is the lack of detailed description of the external and internal interfaces. Expected content of interface documentation are names, types, units, resolutions, ranges, and default values. Without this information, a proper testing of the interfaces in the unit test is impossible. It is okay if the external interfaces are described on architectural level and tested in the software integration test. Aspect 3. When shall the detailed design be documented? Describe the detailed design before you implement the code. Often, the detailed design is described after the fact, meaning after the code has been written. Why is that a problem? Well, the unit test should check whether the code fulfills the detailed design. If you write the detailed design after documenting your code, the point of the unit test is lost. Now, you could argue that you may not need the unit test. The point is that you should derive your detailed design from your architecture and not from the code. If the chain is broken, then suddenly the content of documentation and all the tests do not make sense anymore. So the detailed design must be written before you start writing your code. There's nothing wrong to iteratively develop detailed design and code step by step. So those were the three most important aspects of detailed design. If you want to learn more about software detailed design, we have created a more detailed white paper that you can download for free by clicking on the link below. If you are interested in Automotive SPICE, you can subscribe to this channel. We provide expert knowledge on a regular basis, and don't forget to share this video with your colleagues. Finally, thanks for watching. Good luck and goodbye.